Hey everyone, how's it going? Peter here, and a warm welcome to my latest model train review of this end scale EMD GP30 that is from Atlas, and this is part of the Atlas end scale range of model trains from the classic range. Not sure what year this was made, folks, I have no idea, but I got this one for a fairly good deal pre-owned, and as you know, I do like me American locomotives, so without further ado, let's bring up the details, and here are the details as follows. Reference number is -47512 GP30, and this one is BNSF numbered as 2800, and there is a sticker that was applied by the previous owner of 2800 on the box. So, without further ado, let's pop open the box then, shall we, folks? And let's take a look at what's inside. We're just reaching for a box here, folks, just to stand the lid on, and we will unbox this. First and foremost, here are some accessories, and I'm not sure what you get in here entirely, but there is some standard couplers and some detail parts that you can add yourself if you want to. And this one, folks, just simply to remove it from the box, I just use my finger on a solid part of the model, not the coupler or anything fragile, and I'll just ease it up from the back and just grasp it by the fans, well, the pod, and that's very much that taken care of. Nice amount of weight. There is a working headlight in the middle, as I did give this a wee test before doing this review. All-wheel drive. This is one of the made in China models, so it's not one of the older Mahano or Roco models that was badged as Atlas, if I have those details correct. I might be getting this confused with another brand, but I do believe Atlas and Caro did have a partnership in the 1980s, but I believe this is possibly a 2000s or a 1990s model. But one thing you will notice, folks, there is no traction tires on either truck, and this has got a nice amount of weight as well. It is a good runner, and we will see more of that in the performance test. And this is how it came to me, folks. There is no instructions that came with the model, as far as I know. And I did check inside the box when I originally tested this model. So that, my friends, is the introduction all done. So the next thing for me to do is to cover the close-ups and the rotation, and then we will see how this EMD GP30 will perform in the performance test. Okay, folks, it's now time for me to commence on with the close-ups. As you know, this is the BNSF H2 livery, or Heritage 2, whatever you want to call it. The road number is 2800. Very nice detail for what it is. I don't know how much these models would be in terms of their actual value, but I have seen these on eBay advertised anywhere between £55 right up to £90, so I don't know if that's good value or not, but they're the prices in terms on the eBay UK website I've seen these advertised for. Anyways, I did get this one for a good deal, so I'm not going to disclose how much I paid for mine, as you will pay a different price for yours. And this was pre-owned, folks. Details very nice all round. We do have the air horns above the engineer's side of the cab, and we've got the raised section of the cab as well. There is working lights, folks, but it's just the basic headlights at the front. There is no rear working headlights on this model. I don't know if that's how it's meant to be, but that's how this one runs. And there is some fitted handrails and stuff, but it's not as detailed as some of the other models that I have planned to cover on this channel. and it's not as detailed as the two Caddo models are. Although the detailing on the Caddo models is quite basic compared to some other brands I've seen on YouTube, but it's very much acceptable for what it is, and in my opinion, I do find this is a very nice model from Atlas. Although, to be truthful with you folks, the only other Atlas models I've owned in the past is the HO scale ones, so it will be interesting to see how this one will perform. And this is my very first Atlas N scale model that I've covered. And also, I do plan to cover the rolling stock in separate reviews as well, as by popular demand, I've been requested to cover rolling stock reviews as well as locomotives and train packs. So look out for those ones. It's now time to do the full rotation, and let's zoom out far enough so we're not going to crop anything, and we will go clockwise as I do this on all of my reviews. But as you can see there folks, it's a very nice model from Atlas. I'm not sure if this is a 1990s or a 2000s model, but let's just adjust that camera just a wee bit there as well, as I don't want to crop anything. So just going to do some of that, keep it all in the filming zone, and of course I'll just put the camera back as we come back towards the front of the locomotive. And that, my friends, is the review done. Well, this part of the review done, and it's time to have some fun with the performance test. And I do have some new wagons, and you will see those in the test run. Well folks, it's now time for us to have some fun, and let's commence on with the performance test then. So without further ado, let's zoom out a wee bit just to give us a nice view. We're still going to stay in close for this lap or two, and I want to show you the new wagons that I do have for my US N scale model train reviews. And this one is just a short one, but what I'm going to do first folks, I'm going to start at the background train, of which is my Caddo ES44AC, and I'm just going to adjust the camera slightly there so that we can see that better. So there we go, and without further ado, let's get some power on the track to the EMD GP30, and let's see what this train can do. We currently crank the power up to exactly 50% power, and as you can see there folks, I've used just a short train for this one because I'm assuming that this GP30 would be used on local switching trains as well. I tend to use the larger locomotives for the longer trains, and I do have 8 on the test train in the background. Well, the Caddo GE ES44AC, as where I've just got 3 random wagons behind the GP30-2, correction, the GP30. And it's quite a nice length train actually for this small locomotive, and it runs really well. This is my very first N-scale Atlas I've ever covered on this channel folks, and it's the first N-scale Atlas model that I have actually owned. I've never owned anything from Atlas in N-scale before, but truthfully, from how it's running, and I will zoom out in a moment just to show more of the model rail. In fact, I'll do that now. So let's zoom out a wee bit and let's just see this model railway. Well, see the more of the model railway as the GP30 enters the filming zone. It runs really great. Quite a nice puller. I do like the knuckle couplers, as I prefer these to the other ones, which are the rapido couplers, as I don't like those rapido couplers or rapido couplers too much. So I prefer these knuckle type couplers as they look far more realistic, but that's just my opinion. Most of the wagons, by the way folks, these are made by Micro Trains, and apart from the hopper that's behind the GP30, that's made by Atlas, but the rest of the wagons, they are made by Micro Trains, and they do seem to be quite solid quality, and they are quite weighty compared to my UK wagons that I've used with the British trains that I've reviewed. So that's grand. And I thought I'd use my BNSF GE ES44 AC just to add a nice contrast of BNSF trains into this review, as this is my first Atlas model and it is a BNSF locomotive, so it does contrast well, and I do like the quality on the model. As you can see, very smooth runner, almost silent running, and in truth these models are very good value for money. It depends on the railroad operator you want to go for as how much you will pay for these models, but all in all folks, I do recommend them. And what I will do, I will just do another angle, and then after that I will do, well, start to wrap up this review. And in truth, I'm liking this, and I do have many more US model trains reviews to come, although well, as you know, I did cover a lot of rolling stock reviews back in May, and I will do some reviews of these wagons as well, so that will keep the model train content coming on this channel for most of the year, as I will contrast it with rolling stock and locomotive reviews. And to be honest with you folks, I really do like this model, and the headlight, I'm not sure if that's LED or a bulb, as I've just ran this straight from the box and it does run really, really well. As far as I know, I don't think it's DCC ready, although to be truthful, I've not removed the body shell to find out, but it does have all-wheel drive. It is a very nice smooth runner, and you can see the performance for yourself. Okay, I will have a couple more passes or so, and I will switch the camera just to show another angle, and then it will be time to start wrapping up this review of this Atlas EMD GP30 in the BNSF Heritage 2 livery. So as soon as I get the filming zone clear, I will do, well, swap the camera around. So I may get two, maybe three more passes before I need to, well, until I get a clearing, and then that way I can then adjust the camera. Bossy folks, I really do enjoy doing these reviews, and it's nice to have some proper American rolling stock. I may well get some hoppers just to lengthen the second train, as I think 8 wagons behind this GE ES44 AC is long enough for this size model railway anyways, but I want to get some hoppers, some grain hopper wagons, to add a nice contrast to this small model railway of mine. Anyway folks, I'm just waiting for a clearing and I will adjust the camera now. Well, as you can see folks, there is no working tail lights on this model, and as far as I know, even when I did run this model in reverse, there is no working headlights on the back end of the train. Unlike the Caro SD70M and the ES44AC models that I've previously reviewed, there is no working lights on the back. I don't know if this is how it's designed or if there is a bulb inside that may have failed, but the only working lights on this model is just the centre headlights above the carb. But in truth, as you can see there, it runs really smooth. It's almost silent running and it just glides along the rails and it can handle the three wagons with ease. At this present time that I'm done this review, I don't have any further wagons to really test the hauling capabilities of this smaller diesel locomotive. But if I had, in ideal situations, I would like to have about maybe 10 to 12 wagons per line for this size model railway, of this length of wagons anyways. But all in all, as you can see there folks, it's a very nice runner. Sadly, no working tail lights, although there is no tail lights on the real things. I think it's just a DPU light, but I'm assuming at the time this model was made, that technology did not exist. And I'm assuming that the headlight is possibly an old style bulb. I don't really know. But truthfully, that's this portion of the video covered. So once I get a clearing, I will start wrapping up this review. But as you can see for yourself, very nice solid runner. Okay folks, what I'm going to do is start wrapping up this review now. The good parts about this model, it's a very nice, smooth and solid puller. It can handle this small test train with ease, as these wagons are heavier than my UK models are. So I do like the fact that the model runs well. There is no stuttering or jerky running, unlike with some other brands. And as far as I know, I'm assuming this model is not DCC ready. I could be wrong, but I've not taken the model apart to find out. And I do have a lot to learn about the Atlas N scale range of model trains, because to be honest with you folks, this is my very first one that I've covered on any model train review on this channel. But I do plan to cover many more different types of models in N scale, as I really do like the American model trains. So all in all, the detail, most of it is molded, but I'm assuming this is a 1990s release model, I don't know. So detail and features, I'm going to give that a 4 out of 5. Performance, I'm going to give that a 5 out of 5. I mean, if you can see on the video, it runs really well, almost silent running, and I do like the fact that it's got the proper US style couplers, so that's good, that's good. And although there's no detailed cab interior as far as I can tell, as I think you can just see the metal chassis through the windows. But in truth, this is a 1990s model. For performance, I'm going to give out the full 5. The quality, I can't see any fuzziness on the decals or the lettering, so I'll definitely give that a 4 out of 5. For the reasons is, the windows are not flush glazed on this model, folks, so that's why I'm going to say 4 out of 5 on the quality. And the final category I need to cover on this one is the prices. Now, how much I paid for mine, for what it is, I'll probably give that a 4 out of 5 as well. So, for me, that rounds this review off with a 7 out of 10. And a 7 out of 10 for this one, folks, is a fair and a justified score. It's a great runner. Depending on the livery that you want this GP30 in, the prices can vary considerably. I've seen these as cheap as £55 to as much as £85 to £95. So that's just a guide, folks. I'm not declaring how much I paid for mine, as you will likely pay a different price for yours. But all in all, folks, that concludes this review. As always, please do let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I do read and respond to all comments, folks, so please feel free to post your feedback, post your comments, and I'm always happy to answer any questions in terms of model trains and end scale. If I know the answer, I'll post it. If not, I'll just say I don't know, because I like to do these reviews with honesty, integrity, and morality. And that's what my channel is all about, folks. Okay, right, that's all said and done. That concludes this review. Big thank you for watching. Take care of yourselves and each other. All the best, God bless, and look after yourselves and look after each other, okay, folks? I will see you in the next review. If you are here for my model train reviews, they are every Saturday at 11 a.m. UK time, as they are scheduled to go live on the channel. Well, to be posted on the channel every Saturday at 11 a.m. UK time. And if you do like the Let's Plays, they are every Monday, Wednesday and Thursday, just in case you stumbled across this video and you are new to my channel. And if you did enjoy the video, please do leave a like on it, please. And if you're not already a subscriber, please do hit that subscribe button. I'll see you in the next one.